Hey everyone, I am here at San Onofre State Beach at our Bluffs campground. We have 6 trails that lead to the beach and I am at trail 1 on this beautiful, gorgeous day. Almost looks like a painting behind me today. And I would like to talk to you today about the gray whale. And if you have kids at home, hopefully they'll enjoy this book I'd like to read and show you some of our gray whale artifacts. My name is Cryssie Moreno and I am a state park interpreter, which means that I interpret the natural resources of the park to the visitors when they come here. So I lead school groups and junior ranger programs and all the educational programs here at our park. So every year the gray whales go south to Baja California, Mexico, and pass right by our park here. And I've actually seen them down here when I've been on the beach, and I've seen them stick their heads up and look around, which is called spy hopping. I've seen them rolling in the sand right by the shore, and I've even seen them breathing out of their blowhole out there in the ocean. And it really sparked an interest the first time I saw a gray whale, and I wanted to learn more about it. Maybe that's happened for you before when you've been at a state park or camping and you want to learn more about something that you saw that was special to you. So that's how I feel about the gray whale. It's one of my favorite animals in the ocean. And I have this neat book. My kids love it. Hopefully you'll enjoy it too. And then I'll show you some gray whale artifacts after. So this is called Little Gray's Great Migration, and it is written by Marta Lindsay, illustrated by Andrea Gabriel. Little Gray popped his head above the water to look for his favorite thing. There it was, a boat full of people was on its way into the lagoon. Little Gray always greeted the people the same way. First, he went right up to the boat for a head rub. Next, he blasted bubbles out of his blowhole, burble, burble. Then he hit the water with his flukes. Slap, slap, slap. Finally, Little Gray jumped as high as he could and smack went the water as he hit the water. The people clapped and shouted. Snap, snap, snap went their cameras. One morning, Mama Gray wouldn't let Little Gray greet the people. "It's time for us to swim to the special sea that's filled with food," said Mama. "Why?" asked Little Gray. "There's plenty for me to eat here." After all, he ate as much of Mama's milk as he wanted. "The special sea is where you'll learn to eat like a grown-up whale," said Mama. "It's also where we'll make our blubber extra thick before winter when there's hardly any food." Little Gray hurried to follow Mama out of the lagoon, but he looked back at the boats the whole time. The ocean was cold and deep. It was so dark, Little Gray could barely see. Sometimes they stopped for Little Gray to drink milk. Sometimes they stopped to rest, but mostly they swam. They swam all day and all night. It was hard work and nothing like the lagoon. Little Gray missed the people so much. The more he thought about this, the sadder he became and the slower he swam. He is with his mama. Up ahead, land stuck out into the water right in their path. "What should we do?" asked Little Gray. He hoped they would have to go back to the lagoon. "We'll have to swim around it," said Mama. Little Gray sighed, but as they swam closer to the land, Little Gray saw something above the waves. What do you think it was? People! Little Gray was so excited, he jumped as high as he could. Smack! A crowd gathered. Snap, snap, snap went their cameras. Little Gray jumped again and again. He hadn't known there would be people along the way to the special sea. As they continued on, people watched Little Gray from the lighthouses and docks, beaches and boats. The more people he saw, the happier he became, and the faster he swam. But then, everything changed. Days went by without seeing any people, and then weeks. Little Gray got sadder and sadder and swam slower and slower until he stopped. But Mama didn't notice. Soon, Little Gray couldn't see her in the dark waters. Mama, squeaked Little Gray. He didn't know which way to go. The water was very quiet. Where was she? Then Little Gray heard something. Knock, knock, knock. Little Gray swam toward the knocking sounds. There was Mama. As he got closer to her, Little Gray noticed something strange. Mama's sides were sinking in. Mama, you look different, Little Gray said. My blubber's getting very thin, said Mama. Little Gray thought about this. Back in the lagoon, there hadn't been any grown-up whale food for Mama. On their journey, Mama had only eaten a few mouthfuls of krill and amphipods here and there. Little Gray had been drinking milk this whole time, but Mama had barely eaten in months. From that moment on, Little Gray didn't think about missing the people. He only thought about Mama getting to the special sea. The more he thought about this, the faster he swam. He swam faster and faster, and they were getting closer and closer when, oh no, said Little Gray. Up ahead, a huge piece of land stuck out into the water, blocking their way. Little Gray knew Mama was too weak to make it all the way around the land. There's a secret passage, said Mama. It's a shortcut to the special sea. But I'm so hungry, I'm having trouble remembering where it is. I'll find it, said Little Gray. See, they're getting closer. See the snow? They're almost up there by Alaska. Little Gray swam back and forth along the land. It all looked the same. What if he couldn't find the passage? Then Little Gray heard something. It was the knocking and popping sounds of hundreds of other gray whales. Getting close. Little Gray followed the sounds a little farther. There it was. He'd found the passage. As they entered the passage, everything changed. The water got greener. The knocking got louder. The passage got wider. Then it opened up to the vast sea. Right away, Mama dove down to the bottom. Little Gray followed. Mama sucked up a big mouthful of mud. Mama used her tongue to push the mud out through her baleen. Swoosh! When Mama opened her mouth, Little Gray could hardly believe what was inside. Mama swallowed it all with one big gulp. Little Gray decided to try. He sucked up a mouthful of mud. Swoosh! Gulp! It was pretty different from milk, but yum! Getting the food. And this is what they eat. Little microscopic creatures. Little Gray popped his head above the water to look around. A sea lion clapped her flippers together. Whap! A gull flying above Little Gray squawked. Caw! A beluga whale sent a big bubble toward Little Gray. Bloop! Why, this might be more fun than the lagoon. Little Gray blasted bubbles out of his blowhole. Burble, burble. Then he hit the water with his flukes. Slap, slap, slap. Finally, Little Gray jumped as high as he could. And that is the end. He's excited. He's jumping out of the water. He's blowing bubbles. He's slapping his tail against the water. He made it home and he's happy. So the gray whales migrate along our coast every year and go down to Baja California, Mexico, and that's where they give birth to their young, the calves, and they nurse their young for a few months until they get strong enough and enough blubber on them to start making their journey back up north. back up to the seas in between Alaska and Russia. And that's where they spend the summers. Then in the fall, they'll migrate back down along our coast after they get their food and nutrients up there. And they come down in the fall along our coast here. And then they spend the winter down in Baja California and then back up our coast in the springtime. So this is about the time of year you'll see them heading back up to their feeding grounds up north by Alaska. So I wanted to show you a couple gray whale artifacts that we have that we found here at the park. And this one is called baleen, and it's actually hangs from the jaw of the gray whale along their mouth. This is facing the outside, and this is on the inside of their mouth. And some whales, including gray whales, don't have teeth. So they're filter feeders, and they filter their food by using this baleen. So when they scoop up all that water and mud, they push the water out and all the food sticks to this, those little tiny krill and amphipods that they eat. They're little tiny microscopic creatures, but they eat tons and tons of it every day. This is what sticks to the, that's the food that sticks to the baleen, and then they swallow it. So this is kind of like a filter or a strainer. So if you've ever used a spaghetti strainer at home and you scoop up, you pour the water and the noodles into your strainer and then all the water goes out and what's left in the strainer, your food. So that's kind of how this works. And this is made out of the same stuff our fingernails and hair are made out of. It's made out of keratin. And this is the part that attaches to the jaw, and it's just lined all along their mouth. This is just one piece of it. And then I have this bone. What do you think this is? This is from a gray whale. I'll show you the shape of it. I want you to feel all the way up your back, all these little bumps that go all the way up your back. In the middle of your spine there, those are our vertebrae, and they're stacked on top of each other all the way up your spine, and they're about this big around our vertebrae. This is a gray whale vertebrae, just one. And same thing, they're stacked all along the whale's spine. So that's one gray whale vertebrae. And then I have this bone. What do you think this is? I have to back up so you can see it. This is a rib bone. So there would be one here on this side. And this would be the other side. And same thing, they're stacked all along their chest area, like us. So you can feel your rib bones here and all the way up. This is just one of the gray whale's rib bones on one side. So gray whales are about 45 to 50 feet long. Blue whales are 100 feet long. So gray whales are about the half the size of a blue whale. So about 45 to 50 feet long. And they feed on those amphipods, krill, tiny microscopic creatures, but they're one of the largest mammals on Earth. I hope you get to see these beautiful creatures one day. And I hope you enjoyed the program, and I'll see you in the park soon.